and I have explained everything, the working around of the platform. Now going back on the chart, let's say this is the chart which I'm here. I have already explained how the time frames work. You simply have to, you know, at the bottom of this time frame, you want some specific time frame, you can add that time frame. You go across at the bottom and you will be able to see how to add a time frame. I'm actually not able to show you this here. Let me just see if I can shift it. Yeah. So I've shifted this panel here. You can see you can add these time frames, your customized time frames, and then you can mark these star markings. So once you have done that, these time frames will be available here. So it makes your analysis work easier. Like I want to, you know, navigate from a daily to a weekly chart. I can quickly jump to weekly, monthly, and something like this. I can easily see how the charts are. This is a totally very responsive chart, very fast to react. So you can see how you can use them. So and these are the chart types available here. Direct, these are my favorite chart types. So if you just go here again, there's a star marking, so you can pick up your favorite chart types. And some chart types are available as your premium user only. So you have to just compare that user, this thing which I have suggested you at bottom in the pricing section. You need to cross check what features are available as a specific user, free user, pro and pro plus premium. So there's a comparison to, you know, feature wise there. You have to refer this and come back on the chart and see whether that feature is available to you or not. So that's how about the chart types. And there's an indicator, you can just these are favorite indicators, you can just pull up an indicator here, search any indicator, you can pull up financials of the company from here. This is the place where you can just pull up your, you know, templates, my templates, that something like, you know, by default I've done some drawings and analysis, then I want to keep this as a specific, let's say this is not going to be specific, this is specifically for, you know, Nifty only, so I cannot apply this as a template. Let's say many moving average use kiya, some moving averages I used to use as a template, and you can save it and apply that as a template from here. So directly templates available, you can mark them as a star and pull up that as and apply them. There's an alert available here, you can put up these alerts on the price, on the drawing tools, all those things available here. Even crossing, you can put up indicator also. Up indicator dalenge to, there'll be available two of them, RSI and all the indicators will be available. So you have to choose the condition and you can put up these alerts. There's a bar replay. This is a wonderful feature. You know, once, let's say you have done that bar replay, you can, once you've done the analysis, now let's say I want to see how it has run post a specific time, then you can run that. You can forward it, or you can just check it around, fix up the speed, and then you can just play around. So once you have played, you will just know how it has actually moved according on the chart. So this is how it is just moving, and whatever you have updated as this thing. And then you can even do you know, take a video recording of this also. You can publish the idea from here, do a specific title can be put up, you can contribute your analysis, first learn from the community, and then you can do that, and you can do it as an analysis, as a tutorial. So whatever is it, you can pick up all these options. You can share it with your Twitter handle, this thing, Twitter. If it is a normal idea, then it is only Twitter. And if it is, let's say you have, you're doing a video, then in video, what happens, you get an extra tab here, that is YouTube. You know that you can even share your ideas to YouTube also. So your Twitter handle, YouTube, everything, stock tweets, everything is available. So it's simply, it is an amazing this thing, tool where you get a lot of things to be done. So how would you use these features? Once you come on the front page, let me just come back on my sign-in page. And I'll show you, there's a drop down here. So you can go across on your profile page. You can just check all these options available. Your profile settings are there, update status, account and billing. You can talk to the support team for a specific subscription model, some data you're looking out. You can refer friends. So there's a help center, idea published. Now, all those things are available. You can check all of them and sign out, obviously. If you are just wanted to leave TradingView, then you can finally sign out the TradingView. That's so I have I guess I've run across along the TradingView platform. So that was you know all about TradingView platform. Basically, I've pulled up everything for you on how the working around of the TradingView platform happens and how responsive, how smooth the TradingView's platform. Now coming back at the bottom of the website, we'll just wind up this section. Everything all about TradingView. Suggested how TradingView came into existence was came into existence just to empower investors, traders, and investors so that they make their decisions about financial markets. And this is the fastest way to follow markets. If you want to follow markets, then you have to come across the de facto platform that is TradingView. And as a business partner, if you're looking out some solutions, then you can refer all these things. And there's a partner program also. You can become our partner. Over there's a referral program is there. There's an advertising, there's a broker solutions. As a website owner, you can approach us. All the email IDs are mentioned over there. You can pull up as an individual subscriber, you can check out the features. And the first thing, if you are the first time user, then make sure that you are actually, reading all about TradingView, how it works. And there is a house rule, which is most important, which you have to refer. House rules is a must important because there are a lot of users who are actually coming and they're doing some kind of negativity. Negativity, I mean, they're using a lot of abusive things, so which is not allowed. These are strictly no at the TradingView platform. So make sure that you're reading house rules carefully, going through each and everything, clearly. Everything is clear across you. You're just here to learn about TradingView and help others and contribute to the TradingView community, right? And moderators, if you want to check them, you can check here. People here, Pine Wizards are there. So chat, you can refer friends, ideas, and all these the tabs are available. You can check them in your leisure time. And more details here. If you're a fundamental user, then you can check here, the earnings calendar and economic calendar and all those market and help center is there. So that's all about TradingView. Now coming back to this, I have covered the time frame, the chart types, the indicators here, how you can simply pull up a indicator like this. If you're putting up an indicator, you can put up this indicator. Moving averages are there right now here. You can just see there's an EMA here on your top left. It's not visible actually. My background is green. Pardon me. That's actually because I have something related to this background. My brand logo, my personal logo is there, which is of that similar kind of thing. So that's why I've chosen this background. So now coming back to this EMN9, there's a lot of us, you can do all inputs, style, settings, and that's available. Now, there are tools which, if you're putting as this XABCD pattern, let's say I've just put up this tool here, and I don't want this tool to be visible in weekly chart. Now, if you just go into weekly chart, you can see them here on the weekly chart as well. If I go here on the monthly chart, I'll see this chart. I'm not able to see in the weekly chart. Why that is so? If you just make a right click, settings, you go into visibility, and you can see here, this is the drawing tool, which is not available in the weekly. And if I click this check or uncheck, you will be able to see on a specific time frame. So I want to see them. I don't want to see them only. It is unchecked. So now if I just go into a weekly chart, I will be able to see this. Can you see this? So it is available here on your this thing. All facilities are available here on the drawing tools. Make a right click and just fiddle around with the tool. You will be able to understand what all features are available here on drawing tools. There's a log scale. If the price scale is too much of history is available. So you can just pick up a log scale. You need to understand when to use a logarithmic scale, auto scale, arithmetic scale. There's a percentage scale. So all these features on your all data is available. You can click all data. You can take only one data. So you can take that. It will automatically shift to 1 minute chart if you're doing a one day time frame. So because in 1 day, you can just see only this much. Yeah, you can scroll it on your you keep scrolling and you will get some, you'll keep getting that data. You have to wait for a few seconds to for data to populate, or to need to wait for that time, to, you know, upload for on the platform. So that's how you can pick up these time frames. There's a specific go-to date. If you want to go certainly in some 5 years, you know, up the line, 5 saal pehle jana hai, to specifically you can choose that. You cannot keep scrolling the screen for 5 years back. That is not possible. Yeah, because time is very precious. Sabke paas time bahut kam hai. 24 ghante milte hain sabke paas, right? So me too. So go to is one of the option where you can pick up your specific calendar wise, and you can specifically move in that this. And if you once you have pressed auto and you have pressed this icon tab here, it goes directly on your extreme end of the chart frame. I've already explained all these features, how you can publish them, how you can do a video idea. You can do a video idea, so continue that idea, and you can learn all these things in these three dots. There are three horizontal lines here. You can click them, and this is the stock name. These are recently stocks. You can pull up from here also, or if you want to pull up your all layouts, if you click this all layouts, all your charts will be available in the, you know, column wise, and you can pick up any of them, whatever you have visited so far, or recently a couple of them, four of them are available here right now. Make sure that whatever you're doing, it is auto save, but still you have to on this auto save every 5 minutes. It gets auto save whatever you're doing this thing. Sharing, if you want to share, then allow this share, then you can on this, off this, make a copy, rename copy, export chart data. I'm not sure, you need to check about the sharing that data, because that is not available. You cannot share it outside, but still you can check across. Here it is your profile page, a profile settings and account billing for your use as a user, help centers available, refer friends, and all these options. What's new? So this is the most important tab, which as a user, if you are a trading user, a professional user, or a first time user, every morning when you open up a chart, you just go on these three lines. Make sure that you come across and just check this. Why? Because this is the place where all latest details are happening. This is the blog where you would you will get all updates. The blog updates are there. What are the latest releases at trading? You know, MCX data, NSA futures data, everything has come up as a blog. So how would you know that there's a blog? There will be a number. You must have noticed there is a red color numbering happens in your this thing, 1, 2, or 3. So you have to quickly come here and go into what's new and just open up that blog and read them. You can open up a dark color theme, so which is already my this thing profile page is already there. So if I go here on the TradingView homepage, you would just see it's dark color theme is available right now. So that's this is the homepage of TradingView. Let me just quickly run off for the TradingView homepage. The ideas are the place where you have to follow authors, asset classes. You can just go across all asset classes, trend analysis. These are the analysis which are, you know, segregated as a trend analysis. Harmonic pattern analysis is available. So if you are putting as a tag, it'll be available here in this section. Chart patterns, technical indicators, all these are available here as markets. If you just you want to refer markets when you are there for global markets and all those, so you can come here in currencies. You can check major currencies, minor, exotic, Americas, Europe, Asia, Asian currencies, all of them is available. So right now, since you are there on IN.TradingView, so whenever you open up markets and you go into currency, obviously by default USD INR will be as one of them, because that's a local currency. Stocks is there, top gainers, top losers, most active stocks, most volatile, overbought, oversold, all-time high, all-time low, all these indices. You go into indices and check what's happening across global markets. S&P is down, NASDAQ is down, DAX is down. So this is a quick recap, summary for what's happening across the globe and all your European markets, US indices, S&P sectors, current, or major world indices. So you can just check them at your comfort. Futures are available here, so you can check them. All the commodity data is available. That's how you can just run across the platform with the ideas, markets, scripts. I've already suggested my friend and colleague Rajendran, Market Calls, one of the best one. You have any doubts with the Pine programming, your technical query, he's the one to approach. So you can always bombard him with a lot of questions. He'll be happy to answer answer all your questions. Now, screeners, you need to check across stock screeners. There's a Forex screener available, brokers. So brokers, unfortunately, there's no broker here in India. We are just working around. In futures, definitely there'll be someone there, and there'll be end of the tunnel. You know, there'll be light at the end of the tunnel. So, and one day you will be able to trade directly from the TradingView charts. So that will be the time when everyone will be delighted to, you know, be part of TradingView, because you can directly trade from TradingView charts. Now, these are your charts and more features available here. You can just check them. I've already explained at the bottom of the website. So as a business, as a community, about sections, pricing, help center. So I guess I have run everything on the TradingView platform. Now it's up to you. You have to just go across and just, you know, in your leisure, just run across everything, every tab, open up a chart, just make a right click, do left and right, whatever you want to do. You know, that's how, the way how you have to learn. Aap sikhoge kaise? You have to learn this way, new things. You know, to explore new things, go in and out every time, spend a lot of time and understand why it is happening, how it is happening, ask a lot of questions. One thing I've learned, these days, as a mature person, when you start, growing from your childhood to become an adult, you stop asking questions. That is the basic problem for all people who want to, you know, educate themselves, learn, become a learned person. How you can become more and more eager? Aap kaise progress kar sakte ho? How will you progress yourself? You have to ask a lot of questions. Aapne dekha wo chote bacche ko, the kid who is 5 years old, he always asks, how this train runs, why this train runs, why this train goes round the clock, why it is not going down, why it is not going up. So, you know, he's asking a lot of questions, which we as an adult have stopped asking questions. If you have stopped asking questions, then you have stopped your journey. So don't stop your journey of learning. Learn and be part of a family where we together can grow. That's all. I just stop my presentation with this. I would hand over to now Rajendran to take it from here.
Thank you, Abhishek, for running up through all the features of TradingView. It is a very short session, by the way, so hardly we have less than a hour to spend time, and Abhishek has to run through all the features, and that's been a crazy features that has been built in TradingView. I would say that a million users, more than a couple of millions users platform. So obviously I would add salute to all the features, all those innovative features that TradingView had provided. And absolutely, it's a beautiful interface, and hats off to that interface. And the way the TradingView has been evolved over the period of years, right? Absolutely, it had changed the community of traders, right? So now, when it comes to Indian market, right? So NSE and MCX data, availability, that too, the real-time availability of those data, right? So which is freely available in TradingView platform. If you're not aware about that, I guess Abhishek also spoken about NSE and MCX futures data, which is available on the platform at free of cost, right? I've been a primary user of NSE cash predominantly because completely clean data of split bonus adjusted data is available over there. The question is like, is it a basic version free for beginners and how to get this done? This is a question from Gaurang. I guess the basic version is free, and ample amount of features in TradingView is coming at free of cost. And only if you want to go with advanced features like webhook, or in case if you want to access to real-time markets, US markets in real time, there will be charges, I guess. And I guess probably Abhishek is the best person to answer about those things. To my knowledge, I guess 70% of the features are available at free of cost. And yeah, a couple of features like multiple layouts. If you want to see charts in multiple layouts, or if you want to send the alerts to your broker server, or you want to do automated trading using the webhook feature, which they recently launched, I mean, a couple of months before they launched that, those features, you have to be a pro user or a pro plus user, I guess. And there are a lot of Renko studies available there, couple of 5 second charts or 1 second charts, those kind of second level charts. If you, if in case, if you want to use, I guess it is not available in the free plan, but you have to go to the pro plan, I believe. So while try live trading with other people, broker, use your platform live for taking positional buy or sell. This is from Mukesh. Okay, pretty good, Mukesh. Is it possible to have multiple charts on one screen to track both Nifty and Bank Nifty options? Let me show you. In my case, I'm a pro plan user, right? So probably I'm not sure if you're using broker plan. So if you're using multiple screen, yes, it is possible. And if you want to access any of the public indicators, lot many indicators are available there, because TradingView itself, a trading community where you can find ample amount of codings. If you want to access those codings, right, you can go to indicators, and from the indicators, you can go and access the public library. Like, let's say something like Supertrend, if you want to use, you can just type Supertrend. You will be able to find a lot more indicators over here, which is coded by various different coders. And let's say there is an indicator here and you want to know, you're seeing a small arrow marks here, up and down arrow marks, which are nothing but it is basically a trading strategy. That means you can backtest to those trading strategies. These are trading strategies which comes with buy and sell signals. The rest of all those other things are nothing but the trading terminals, right? So it is basically, it's basically nothing but a trading indicators. Trading indicators doesn't comes with buy and sell, or you cannot do backtesting on indicators, whereas the one which is coming up with these kind of arrow marks, right? So that shows the trading strategies, means you can use the strategy tester to backtest your trading ideas, right? And the backfill from TradingView also pretty much superior, and the quality of backfill is pretty much, kind of authentic data vendors with NSE and MCX. So obviously the data quality is extraordinary, I would say that. So some people are asking, do we have Bank Nifty options on TradingView? TradingView, right? It comes with two different versions. One is it is deployed in TradingView itself. Their options data is not available, but NSE cash and NSE futures data is available. However, if you are using brokers, there are a lot of brokers who deployed a TradingView platform like Zerodha or Upstox or Fires, right? So they've been using TradingView charts as well. If you are using it from the broker's interface, obviously, yes, you can you can access the option charts there. But I guess last time I checked in Fires, I think multi-view option charts are available there. So Aditya is saying that Fibonacci tool, it needs to be manually adjusted. Can it be resolved? So there's a question, like it doesn't pick up. Maybe I'll put it across to Abhishek. Probably Abhishek might be able to answer it. If you are having any queries, right, you can always send all your queries to learn@webinars.com. So hope our team will be helping you out and reaching out with TradingView, Mr. Abhishek, to let you know about the upgrades or any questions. If you have to Abhishek, you can always send a mail to learn@webinars.com. Let me move on to final question. Is there a delay in data feed for free and paid site? Of course, when it comes to Indian markets, right? To my knowledge, Indian data feeds like NSE or MCX, so far it is real time, and it's been real time for quite some time now. Whereas some of the markets like US markets, right? So the free version comes with delayed data for certain symbols. And in case if you want to adapt for real time data, you have to upgrade to the higher plans, I guess. So definitely when it comes to Indian market at this point of time, NSE cash, MCX and NSE futures all are coming in a real time so far. So obviously even with the free version also, you'll be able to make use of TradingView platform. So what is the difference between TradingView platform, investing.com? I guess investing.com also using TradingView. This is a question from Sukumar. Sukumar, let me tell you, like TradingView, right? It is deployed in deployed as a standalone. You can access from TradingView.com. The major benefits is that you can access Pine scripts, whereas the self-hosted TradingView platform, right, which is hosted in the broker's servers, or it is hosted in TradingView, it doesn't comes with Pine script or strategy tester or various features, right? So most of the community features are not available in other self-hosted platform. However, all those platforms are in completely integrated in TradingView.com. Whereas with brokers, you'll be mostly seeing trading terminals or access to watch list. However, PineScript and TradingView kind of interfaces will be missing in even in investing.com as well.
You can hear me, Rajendra?
Of course, I'm able to hear you. I'm able to hear you.
Okay, so I can answer now if something you need me.
Cool, man. Cool. So I guess a lot of questions are there about scanners, right? Can free subscribers use scanners? That is one of the question from Hari Lal.
Yeah, scanners can be available. If you even you are a free subscriber, you can because that feature won't be, you know, cannot be hidden. It is there already available. Once you go on the charts and there's the screener tab is available. Open up any chart on your bottom left. There'll be a stock screener, which is available to all.
And a majority of the questions are from option charts, right? So when we can expect option charts? Even I'm curious to know when we can.
No, options is actually is one of the toughest instrument, which is to be frank enough to be getting plotted on the chart. It's their team is really working hard, but I really cannot commit you any date on this. It's a lot of working required on this. It is not as easy as.
I understand. In a month, there are 38,000 option symbols are there. It's pretty
tough.
Yeah,
so it's very one of the toughest instrument to be, you know, come can, but then surely, you know, it will be there, but cannot commit you time as of now.
Okay, so many people also want to know what is the difference between TradingView platform, which is available in TradingView.com, and the one which is deployed at the broker side, like which is used as a charting interface or a trading terminal interface. So can you explain the difference between both of those?
So the difference is almost visible. If I can show, share my screen. Probably meet yes. Better if you can just give me the thing. I'll share my screen and I'll just quickly pull up a few websites.
Just which,
something like you know, I'll just pull up investing.com. That is the
yes. You website. Can which, now share your screen.
Yeah. So I'll just.
I'm sorry, there was an initial audio glitch was there. Otherwise, it should be the conversation should be much better, I guess.
Yeah, sorry for that glitch, actually. So, investing.com, if you go into the charts and go into the live charts, you would see what is the basic difference between both the charts is you yourself can make out because they are using a library chart from TradingView. And a library
you
chart
have
is...
To share your screen, Abhishek.
Just 1 minute. Am I not sharing my screen? Just 1 minute. Sorry. Yeah. Is it visible now? My screen is.
Yeah, obviously it is.
So investing.com and TradingView, you know, these are all financial partners for TradingView, more than 40,000 financial partners, and TradingView is ranking, within 150 websites among 30 million websites. The reason for this is these charts, which are being used by financial partners, they are provided by TradingView. You can see here, it is just powered by TradingView, all these charts, and they are not of, you can never say that this is a complete charting and this thing, all features available. This is a library chart which we have given to all these financial partners. Certainly, it you would not see some features available on the chart. Now, let's say put up this full blown this thing chart area, you can see all these they have done certain things like the watch list and something is not available at the financial partner end because TradingView is providing these library charts, and library charts is highly customizable. If you are a good programmer, you know how to do a JavaScript, because our library is available in JavaScript, you can do that programming, then you can build up this watch list for your library chart, which we provide. So library chart tools, if you see, these are the drawing tools which are available. The standard, upper panel will be available. Even the alerts are not available. So if you just see the alerts, you would realize that these are not TradingView alert. So the first difference itself is visible here. This is not ours. The layout facility is not ours. You cannot publish the idea. TradingView gives you an option of publishing the idea. So if I just go across on my this thing chart, you would see the drawing tool panel and the top upper panel, the time frame, the indicators, the chart types, options here. You can put up your these alerts which comes up with a lot of features like webhook, sending an email, sending a pop-up, notify on app. You can do so many things on the alert feature. And over here, if you just go on the layout, you have seen this is the TradingView platform layout, and you can just compare their layout. So it is certainly not TradingView's layout, which we don't provide to our financial partners. We are providing just library chart with only basic panel. So what are these? Only the time frames, the drawing tools available, and certain features available. Not even you cannot publish the idea. So which you can do here on a TradingView, you can do. You can publish a video idea, you can do this. So video idea can go onto your YouTube channel, Twitter handle, whatever you do. If you are a premium subscriber, you get to know all these features which I've already explained, like what's new, blog is there, what is the latest development, and all those things. There are multiple things which are available. Now, if you just come across on investing.com, yes, it is, it might provide you some data, which TradingView might not provide, because TradingView is just now providing NSE cash, NSE futures data, MCX data, and which has just happened recently. After a couple of years, investing.com has started providing much earlier than us. This happens because it depends on partner who is taking directly data from the exchange. So we have taken data just now, just a couple of 6 months back only, we have started NSE futures on top of NSE cash and BSE data, which was already available since 2016. Now, 2019, this COVID, when we got into that COVID we just started putting up these data, NSE futures and MCX data, all these data. And now you go into the exchanges also, you would see, this is one of the biggest exchange, Agri Exchange, CME Group, Chicago Mercantile Exchange, how they have put up the library chart. You can just go across on this website and just pull up their charts. So here it is, Quant Futures I've taken, nearest month contract, you can just pull up charts for. If you just scroll down, you would just see all these nearest month contracts available, and there's a charts column is there. So you can just pull up any instrument, and this is the library. This is a standard library which we are providing. In fact, if you compare investing, you cannot make out the difference. But here on the exchange, you would just see what is the difference available. So drawing tools available here. You can see it's clear drawing tools, the time frames. These are standard availability. Can you see? So there's no alert function available. There's no layout facility. You cannot publish the idea and all these facilities. If you just go across here, at bottom, there are a lot of tools which are not available. Now in Nifty, if you go, you would see layout is available on TradingView option, which I've suggested. Alert is available. You have a bar for a replay feature. Bar replay, you can just play or how the markets have moved post you have published the idea. So right, it's better to show your user base that this is how it has moved, the prices have moved. And now at bottom here, you can just see the stock screeners, technos, you can write your notes, Pine Editor, which Rajendran has been already explaining, the best one, person to a strategy tester, a trading panel, your brokers will get connected here in future. Unfortunately, no broker here from India as of now. And then future, surely we'll see a lot of brokers here getting paneled here. And one day you can start trading directly from the charts. So this is all is there available. Now, Rajendra.
A couple of questions on payments. Like most of the people are seeing that the payments are in USD. Like, is there a way like INR payments can be done? Or a couple of people are saying that it currently supports.
Yeah, there's a trading user, you know, foreign based entity, we are currently accepting only dollar based payments. So we are not going to, because there's a lot of fluctuation happening. And that is the reason why, you know, the management has decided that they would not accept INR payments as of now, and maybe in future change. The decisions can change, but then as of now they are just accepting, you know, dollar payments. And I'm afraid to say this, but then that is a fact. If you are scared about that you are making payments is not safe, then you can pull up PayPal. You can make up your payments through PayPal. You can even make your payments through a debit card, which is safe, I guess, using the debit card numbers. And that is not, you know, used. So PayPal is the must safer thing. Panel which can be used for making payments if you are scared about, you know, making payments.
There is one question from Chandrasekharan. Like in TradingView, is there any possibility of providing level 2 or level 3 data? Like
See, certainly level 2 data, level 3 data, as you know that we have just took almost like 3 years to put up NSE futures and MCX. In future, surely these data will be part of our trading group, but then eventually it will take time. Yes, it would be there, but I cannot assure you exactly what is the expected time. You know that 2016, we started with NSE cash and BSE data and almost took 4 years for NSE futures and MCX data to be up. And that happened because of a lot of feedback. So as a community, you have to pass a huge number of feedback. You have to put up, you know, a huge feedback on trading your Twitter handle. You need to come up as a masses. You know, there are millions of you know, users have to put up that. It should go right across to the management, and then only they can decide. So that is the best way. I have already suggested that if my screen is visible, so I have already suggested how you can pass up your feedback. You can just pass your feedback here. There's some section where you can just pass your feedback. If I'm sure. Feature request. So there's a feature request here. So in feature request, you can you create a post and you can put up. But then there should be, you know, a lot of comments happening to one particular post or something, and you need to share it across. You know, it should be a one common post, not a, you know, not thousands of posts from all users. It should be one post, and everyone should be coming on that post and, you know, making it a very popular and just requesting that what you. So that should come from all millions of users. Then only management will be in a position to decide that.
There is one more question about alerts. Like there is a question on how we can, I mean, can we create an alert with a combination of multiple indicator combinations? Like, is there a way that is possible?
See that these manually, that is not possible. If you're looking out multiple, I come back again, multiple alerts, as in like in multiple indicators you want
multiple
to put up
on the combinations, let's say RSI and MACD combination, and then
so you can just put up these indicators here. Let us try, just give a shot here. So let's say I have put up a RSI here, and now I want to add up MACD. So you can just doing this MACD, and then there's an RSI. If I want to put up some alert, let me just see. I want to put alert crossing. So here it is. If you just go into condition, you would see the stock, or you would see EMA, because that EMA is being used here on the chart, or you can see RSI or MACD. So if you can just put RSI, pick RSI and then choose RSI, you want RSI crossing what? So you can choose that option. And
from the interface, we can have only one condition at a time, but if you are using Pine scripts, right, we can, I guess, we can go as many conditions as we want. If you want.
Yeah, so you can do that in Pine script, if that is only possible through a script only.
So it means you have to write your own customized programming language in Pine script, and then you can trigger your own alerts based upon multiple combinations of indicators.
Correct. So but you can put up here as one alert and one alert as a RSI, your RSI crossing and something, and then you can close it, and probably you can make a again and add another alert. Now this time choosing MACD. So you can choose that. So if you choose MACD and then you want to pick all these constituents of MACD, then you can do that, choose that as option and put up an alert, histogram and all those MACD line and signal line. So you can choose that constituent of MACD and particularly EMA. So that's how you can do that.
Abhishek, one final question here. Like, what is your take on algorithmic trading like people are doing right now from TradingView using that Webhook features? Can you comment on that?
We are not supporting algo trades, as of now it is not, because it's a complex thing which right now needs a lot of development.
Using this webhook feature, right? So like a lot many players now, you are allowing people to do automated trading using this webhook feature, right?
No, a webhook, I won't be able to comment anything, because that is, would be a feature which is which will recall at your end. It will be some kind of bot which is, you are creating.
It's kind of information which will be transmitted from to the external third party application. Like maybe it can be used for algorithmic.
I know there's a limited information available for webhook, how it is really functional, but there are some few of them who are actually using webhook on a regular basis. I'll have to really find out who are these.
We are also one of the prominent user of webhook.
I would you could just share your experience how webhook actually works.
So probably I guess maybe in a next session I might be thinking of doing this webhook. I already done a couple of videos in webhook, I guess, where we can send automated trading. Like whenever the alerts are getting triggered, right, we can transmit those alerts to webhook, and webhook will communicate to our server to place orders or to notify the apps. So I guess that webhook is a very innovative feature, I would say that.
Yes, definitely. Webhook is one of the features which certainly I would also be interested. If you're calling me, then probably I'll be also a participant too, because I'm very much keen to learn about webhook. Because, webhook has really opened a lot of things. You are putting an alert and you can just see, you can just integrate and call a third party. You can transfer all the alerts to that third party, and that how it really works. It can really work wonders at times. So that's how you can, change your outlook for markets and all instruments. It'll be much easier to handle all the instruments if you are doing multiple stocks at one time. I know there's a limitation, but still, it'll really work wonders if you're using webhooks.
A couple of people are asking about super trend indicator, like the one which I showed, right? So is it available for free? Yes, it is available for free. It is available in the Market Calls platform. You can go to marketcalls.in and you can download it from there. And I'll also publishing today as a public script, which you can download it and you can make use of those indicators. Maybe I'll be sharing you over the mail. I'll be sending you the link to download the TradingView as well. Abhishek, there is one final question about TradingView. Like probably you would have seen TradingView at the start. When you started, only NSE cash is available in real time. But now NSE futures and MCX futures is getting added. Like now, how you see the users growth after adding more and more exchanges to the platform? Like how is the user response?
So user response has been tremendous. I have started handling TradingView since 2016, when TradingView was almost like, a baby for India. In India, when 2016, it was just 40,000 user base in front of me. It was just 40,000 odd, that much grants, K users, 30K or 40K users. Now, TradingView has been getting 7 million unique monthly users. If you just pull up some, data websites like
similar. How it is? Like,
I'm sorry?
7 million, is it worldwide users or just Indian?
No, it's users for India itself. I'm just talking about India geolocation.
It is
7 million monthly unique users who are coming only for TradingView. These are monthly unique.
Worldwide audience, like if you have a number.
So globally, for global listing, we have already crossed somewhere between 12 and 15, kind of 12 plus. Million unique users, monthly unique users who are coming every, and these are unique users who are coming every month. They are not the same users. There are so many new users are coming every month.
So majority of the population in TradingView is from India, if I'm not wrong, then.
come back again.
Majority of the population in TradingView is from India, if I'm supposed to.
Yes, you know, TradingView has become a household name, kind of, as you know, or we all know how the messenger like WhatsApp has become a household name. It's just not I can't see it's far away from here. Maybe some few years from here, 1 or 2 or 3 years maybe down the line, you would just see every standard user, maybe he's not knowing about markets or he's just entering, first time user, you would just talk about TradingView and he would tell you about TradingView. So that would be the time when everyone would be using TradingView. Every home would be using it if he's an interest in financial markets. And that is the reason why TradingView has come up altogether. Why? Because we wanted to empower investors, and this is the vision for TradingView. And how we are doing it, I've already explained. It is our mission, and we are doing it by providing the fastest way to you as a user to access all the data and enhance yourself and make a better financial market decisions.
Wonderful, Abhishek. So I guess in today's session, you had seen a lot of features about TradingView. I hope in the future, right, we'll be talking about more and more features on TradingView. And I guess I'm a very big fan of TradingView. I mean, I also use various tools, but one
of... So me too. I'm also a fan of TradingView.
Big fan of TradingView, I guess. I hope TradingView never surprises us in coming up with new feature. Hope the same thing will be continuing in the future as well. So with this, I thank Abhishek for coming down and taking time to explain the features of TradingView. And thanks for patient enough and rushing up in a small time, trying to give maximum features available. I guess.
I actually rushed up this platform because it's really not possible to conduct a product demo in 1 hour session. TradingView is a platform where you spend 5 hours a whole day, it will be less because I have so many things to explain. If I just go into very minute details,
it's tough to go understand. It's tough to get into each and every minute detail.
Correct.
But I guess a lot of nuances has been there. A lot of hidden features has been there. So I hope we will meet sometime again, Abhishek, to talk about those wonderful features.
It was pleasure, all of you, to be a part of this webinar. I hope you enjoyed the product demo and what Rajendran has to offer you. Maybe you can just come up with all your queries to him, whatever email he has specified for webinars. You can just ask all your questions over there.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, Abhishek, once again. And thanks everybody for coming and joining.
Thank you all.
And hope we will be meeting soon with yet another session. And again, I'll repeat again, you can always send a mail to learn@thereateofwebinars.com. If you have any queries on TradingView or PineScript or anything you want to know about TradingView, you can always send a mail to learn@thereateofwebinars.com. And hope to see you with Abhishek again with yet another session on TradingView. I guess probably in the near future, maybe we might be coming up with some more tools, ideas, and the charting features on TradingView. Thank you, Abhishek, once again for your time, and have a wonderful evening, everyone. Good night.
Thank you all. Thank you, Rajendran. It was a pleasure.
Sure. Thank you.